Hi, welcome back to my channel Infinity for UPSC. Why is Earth geoid in shape? So there are several reasons. I will be explaining all these reasons one by one. Pay absolute attention. First one, it is because of the centripetal and the centrifugal force. So for that, you will have to understand what these two terms mean. Now these centripetal and centrifugal forces, these come into existence when a body is moving. And that movement could be around its own axis or around some another body, say sun. So if it is rotating around its own axis or if it is revolving around some other body, these two forces comes into existence. What is centripetal? I have already told you, if a structure is to be maintained, the central molecule will pull all the molecules towards itself. So that is how a shape is maintained, because the central molecule pulls all the boundary molecules to itself, and that is the reason the molecules in the boundary do not fall off and do not leave the shape, and that is how a shape is retained. So this force that the central molecule applies, that is called as centripetal, that is the inward force pulling everything inward. So that is centripetal. Now what is centrifugal? I have already told you that there is a state of inertia, that is all the molecules and all the planets, they want to continue in the state of inertia. And what is inertia? Every body wants to remain in its state of rest or of uniform motion unless and until it is acted upon by some external force. And what is the situation here? The molecules, are they moving or are they in a state of rest? All the molecules are moving. I have told you, in a solid structure, the molecules are tightly packed. There is no space, and that is how the solid shape retains its shape, because all the molecules are tightly packed and the molecules cannot move outside or inside. So if I have told you that there is no space between them, how are these molecules in a state of uniform motion? You might ask that. See, energy is always acting upon all these molecules. So if there is some sort of energy which is being supplied to these molecules will move. But if they do not have a space to move, they will vibrate within the space available to them. So that means the molecules will vibrate within the position itself. So that is moving. So all these molecules are moving. And what is their tendency? When they are moving, they want to move in a straight path. They do not want to be held up by the central molecule and they do not want to be a part of this shape. So what is happening here? These molecules, they are trying to pull out. So that force which these molecules, which all the molecules applies, that force is called as centrifugal force. That is, they want to move out. This force is applied outwards. Okay, so that is the difference. Centripetal is inward force, centrifugal is outward force. And there is one more thing that you need to understand. Centripetal is actual force and centrifugal is apparent force. That is, this is not real, it is just a virtual force. Why so? See, the molecules, they do not want to fight. But they have to fight because something is trying to hold all these molecules. So this centrifugal force is a result of the centripetal force. So since this is a reaction to another sort of force, it is called as apparent force and not a real force. What is the another fact? These two forces are always equal and opposite. Opposite, we have seen it. One is inward and another one outward. And what is equal? See, if it is not equal, this shape will not be retained. Why so? Because if these outer molecules, if they succeed in moving out, they will fall out and they will not be part of this shape. So this shape will be damaged. And if this central molecule wins, that is, if the centripetal force is very strong and if it attracts everything very strongly towards itself, what will happen? All the molecules will land up on top of each other and everything will try to occupy the central position. That is, everything will be piled up on top of each other. And even that is not supposed to happen. So that is the reason they are always equal and opposite, so that they retain the particular shape. So this is one reason. It is the centripetal and the centrifugal force and the fight between these two forces, because of which the Earth is geoid in nature. Now you might ask that why is it that the bulge is here and not here? For that you will have to understand one more fact. Now I have already told you, suppose if a solid structure rotates, there is an agreement between all the molecules that they will rotate together. Now let us take the case of this molecule. This molecule has to travel the maximum distance because this entire diameter has to be covered twice. That is, it has to move like this and again come back and reach here. And that is when one entire rotation is completed by this molecule. So this molecule has to cover the maximum distance and this molecule will have to cover the least distance because there is just a point here. So the minimum distance is here and the maximum distance is here. Now you might ask another question, why aren't they moving like this? Why are they moving like this? It is because the earth is moving from west to east. And that is the reason you will have to cut this entire structure in a horizontal manner. That is, you will have to dissect it into pieces in a horizontal manner and then you will have to imagine it. Suppose this molecule takes 1 second to complete the rotation and this molecule takes 10 hours to complete the rotation. So what will this molecule convey to all the molecules? This molecule will convey to all the molecules that all of you are supposed to take 10 hours to complete one rotation. Because if you complete faster than that or slower than that, the shape will be damaged. Okay, this will dismantle the shape. So we will have to follow the uniform pattern. That is, all of us will have to take 10 hours and reach the point together. So now what will happen? What is the formula? Speed, distance, time. Speed is equal to distance upon time. So time is fixed. So time is 10 hours. So what will happen to speed? Speed will be maximum here and minimum here because this one have to complete 10 hours and this one have to complete 10 hours but very slowly. So this will move very fast and this will move very slowly. Now what will happen? For that you will have to imagine one more structure. Now suppose this is a children's park. Here you have this circular swing. Okay, and this circular swing has got several toy horses. So when this moves, these toy horses will move outwards. If you have ever experienced this, you might have experienced an outward pull. You might feel as if you are falling out. Why is that happening? When the velocity increases, there is an outward pull. And that is what is observed here. Where is the velocity maximum? The velocity is maximum at this point. Here, this section has to move very fast. So, since the velocity is maximum here, this portion will experience an outward bulge. It will experience an outward pull, similar to what is experienced here. And here the velocity is minimum, almost zero. So there is no pull outwards. And that is the reason there is a bulge here and there is a flattening here. Now there is one more way of explaining this. If you are a technical student, you might know that within the formula of centrifugal force, there is R. What is R? R is the radius. And I have told you that you have to dissect this. That is, you have to cut this into pieces, into horizontal pieces and then study. So, what is the R here? R here is certain value. And what is the R here? If you cut this portion, the value of R is zero. Because radius is the distance between two points. There must be 2 points for you to have a radius. But you just have one molecule here. You do not have 2 points here. And that is the reason radius is zero here. So when the radius becomes zero, the centrifugal force becomes zero. So the force is zero at the poles and maximum at the equator. So that is another way of explaining this. Now there is one more way of explaining it and that is inertia. We had discussed inertia already. So the inertia is the tendency to move in a straight line. So whenever it is trying to move out. Okay, it is almost following a circular path. It is trying to move out, but this pulls it and here the force is maximum because the centrifugal force is maximum here. So it pulls very hard and similarly when it pulls very hard, the centrifugal force, that is outward force, is also very high here. So that is the reason you observe a bulge here. So these are the ways of explaining why Earth is geoid in nature. So that's all from my side for this topic. Please like, share and subscribe this channel if it is helping you. And I'll be back with the next video very soon. Thank you so much.